In this video, you learn how OAuth2 works in Pass for OpenEdge. OAuth2 usage in Pass for OpenEdge is an authorization framework. This framework allows for applications to obtain limited access to user accounts in an HTTP service such as Google, AWS, Azure, GitHub, and so on, without exposing their credentials. A server instance configured for OAuth2 delegates the authentication to a service that hosts the user account, rather than performing the authentication process itself. OAuth2 also authorizes third-party applications to have access to the user account. Pass for OpenEdge supports OAuth2 by validating tokens whose token type is a JSON web token, JWT. These tokens are provided by HTTP services. The HTTP services are referred to as authorization services throughout this video. First, let's take a look at how OAuth2 authorization works. In OAuth2, authorization of a user can be accomplished in several ways, but commonly by using a resource server that provides an interface for validating a user's identity. This is done by using grant types. Grant types are supported by authorization services, which provide an authentication mechanism for social media security. OAuth2 includes four grant types. This video focuses on the authorization code grant. The authorization code grant is the most common, because of its security features and because it has a specific flow. When the user of a browser-based application attempts to log in to a resource server that is configured for OAuth2, the resource server redirects the user to log in to its authorization service. After the user logs into the authorization service, the user is given an authorization code that is used to get a JWT access token. Let's take a deeper look at the authorization grant flow. We'll use a JavaScript client application and Google to help explain this concept. The first step is to register the client application with Google. For a given client application URL, Google creates a client ID and an API key. The client ID establishes the identity of the account, in which the client user must have the API key to communicate with the resource server. After the client ID and API key are created, the client user clicks the Google Sign In button displayed on the authorization server. The authorization server validates the client ID and API key. Next, the authorization server displays a login page. The login page redirects the user to a page in which the user enters their email address and password. The authorization server validates the username and password. If the credentials are valid, then the authorization server returns a token. This token is called the authorization code, and this code can be used by the client application. The client submits an HTTP request to the authorization server for an access token. The authorization server validates the information in the HTTP request and returns a JSON object that includes this information. The access token in JWT format. The refresh token. The same kind of refresh token you get with an HTTP single sign-on. The ID token, a temporary token used to obtain additional details from the authorization server. And the expiration, the token's lifetime. Let's take a deeper look at the JWT token. The JWT token has three different parts. The header, in which specifies the encryption algorithm, in this case HS256, the payload, which has the user information provided by the authorization server, and which the JWT standard refers to as claims. Specifically, the payload indicates scope, information about the scope of the user, ISS, the issuer when this token was issued and its expiration date, JTI, the token's unique ID, AUD, the intended recipients of the token. The OAuth2 server validates the audience whenever the token is used, and a specification of how to perform signature verification. Now let's go over different OAuth2 entities and what each does. The resource owner is the end user who is trying to log into an application. The client is whatever the browser-based application is. The resource server hosts the data service that is requested by the resource owner and validates the OAuth2 token. The authorization server authenticates the resource owner and provides access tokens. A round-trip flow with OAuth2 authorization works like this. The resource owner attempts to access the resource server. the resource owner simultaneously accesses the authorization server. The authorization server redirects the resource owner to a login page in which the resource owner enters their login credentials. The authorization server validates the resource owner's credentials by using the authorization code grant. The authorization server returns a JWT token to the client. Using the JWT token, the client accesses the resource server by passing the token in the authorization header. Let's take another look at OAuth2 authorization, this time when the resource server is a Pass for OpenEdge instance. When a token is sent to a Pass for OpenEdge instance, first the OAuth2 authentication manager validates the JWT token. The JWT token that is supported in OpenEdge includes common, mainstream token signatures. The token in this example uses the token signature HMAC, which stands for Hash-Based Message Authentication Code. The other token signatures supported by OpenEdge are JSON Web Keyset and RSA. After the token is validated, Pass for OpenEdge converts the token to a client principal object and authorizes the scope of the user's resource URIs. For more information, search for the following topics on the Progress Information Hub. Authenticate using OAuth2 and JWT. Configure OAuth2 or JWT token validation services. Steps to generate an access token using OAuth2 authentication. Configure JWT signature field validation. This concludes the Learn About OAuth2 support in Pass for OpenEdge video.